The Last of Us was a successful game that told the story of the journey of Joel and Ellie across the post-pandemic America in an attempt to deliver Ellie to the Fireflies, a group that was purported to be able to extract a cure for the cordyceps from the immune Ellie. During their journey, we learnt about Joel, and we even got to play some of his past before the outbreak. However, we never got the opportunity to learn as much about Ellie. Sure, there were snippets of dialogue, but most of the time she didn't reveal too much about herself. Joel's stoicism didn't help with that either. That's why I was glad when I played The Last of Us Left Behind. At the end of the core game, we learned that Ellie was suffering from survivor's guilt. However, she didn't provide any further information about this, and again, Joel didn't press for any information either. Left Behind gives us an insight into the loss she experienced, whilst also highlighting the events following Joel's near-fatal injury during their journey. Some questions that weren't answered in the core game are elaborated upon, and for that I am grateful. There are two distinct narratives contained within Left Behind. The first is how Ellie managed to save Joel's life between the events of him sustaining a life-threatening injury in autumn to the beginning of winter, where she has managed to patch him up herself. The other is a prequel of sorts that explores Ellie's character in a lot greater depth than we have ever seen before. We get a feel for what makes her tick and why she has survivor's guilt. The two narratives operate as a duality. Ellie's past acts as an insight into her background and the point where she still had her innocence. This is contrasted with the present time, where for the first time in her life, she has to fend for herself. Previous to this, she could rely on other people for protection, but now it's Joel relying on her, which matures her as a character. Together, both past and present represent major changes in Ellie's life, which shaped her into the young woman we saw at the end of The Last of Us. Both narratives take part in a shopping mall, which contrast harshly with each other. Where past Ellie can enjoy rummaging through artifacts of a time before the pandemic, present Ellie must persevere against not only infected, but also the humans that are pursuing her. Where in the past, Ellie experiences jubilation in riding on a merry-go-round for the first time, present Ellie must use her wits to avoid being electrocuted by water dancing with live wire electricity. This harsh juxtaposition works well to highlight the difference that even a short amount of time can have on how dilapidated an environment can become, and how aggressively the Earth takes back its territory. The no-nonsense approach that Ellie takes to solving the latter problem also shows how she has developed as a person, even in the short amount of time she has been in Joel's company. The two scenarios contrast the different states of Ellie's persona, that of a curious but happy Ellie, with that of an Ellie that will do anything to survive and preserve Joel's life. Ellie is smaller and less capable in battle than Joel, so rather than running at enemies, engaging in fisticuffs, and finishing everything off with a sound thump to the head against a hard surface with a satisfying crunch, battles become an art of precision. Your limited amount of ammo must be used sparingly in order to ensure Ellie's survival. Additionally, Left Behind grants the opportunity to use enemies against each other. For the first time, you will engage with infected and human enemies at the same time. Whilst in concept this makes me groan, because you all know how much I loved the battles in the core game, this actually works pretty well. As usual, there are a number of bricks and bottles scattered around the area. Using these tactically, you can throw one into a group of human enemies, and the resultant sound and human startlement will ensure that clickers will descend upon the enemy humans rather than upon Ellie. You could go the stealth option too and pick off the enemies one by one, but some enemies usually travel close to each other, so this can be quite difficult, especially when they are in each other's line of sight. When exploring the shopping mall in present time, because of Ellie's size, it's easier for her to squeeze through smaller spaces that Joel wouldn't have been able to fit in. Areas that may have been inaccessible to him are able to be explored by Ellie, opening up more options in terms of how you approach not only how you explore, but also how you choose to battle your opponents. I found that hiding in a small space made it easier to pick off enemies, particularly the clickers and infected. What also sets Left Behind apart from the core game in terms of gameplay is the addition of pseudo-minigames. These come in the prequel section in the form of a Super Soaker battle, an imaginary arcade game, a photo booth, and other smaller events. These games help to flesh out Ellie's character far more than what we were able to see in the core game. So rather than being a minigame that you play as the player and experience to enjoy, you get to witness Ellie trying something for the first time, and experience her wonder and amazement alongside her. Framing the games this way was a good decision by Naughty Dog, as it makes you, the player, connect with Ellie on a deeper level, and share in her joy. Returning to voice Ellie is Ashley Johnson. Joining her is Riley, voiced by Yanni King. First appearing in a supplementary comic, Riley is a long-term friend of Ellie. They both grew up together in the Boston quarantine zone. Due to this pre-established relationship, Ellie is more animated and expressive when around Riley. The comfort she has in the other girl's presence allows her to be herself. The rare, beautiful moments between Ellie and Riley are captured perfectly by Johnson and King.
You ever seen anything like this?
Are we just done talking?
I don't know, are we?
You don't get to be pissed off at me.
Even though the two know each other well, and we join them for such a short time, there is a level of development between both characters that is expertly pulled off by the writers. Again, as per the core game, I must commend the way the writers handled an LGBT narrative. So I'm definitely looking forward to where this develops in the future. Left Behind is a perfect example of how DLC should be done for a game. With the duality of the prequel and the present-day scenarios played out within each other's narratives, we were able to explore the maturation of Ellie as a character. I think if the DLC had have been just more of Joel, it wouldn't have been as interesting, considering some of the revelations we got about Ellie. This DLC also got me excited for the next game, which is expected to be released in the middle of 2019. Now, if only I can find another game like this to tide me over until its release. By the way, what is your favourite narrative game? As you know, I am a sucker for games with a deep story. Please let me know your favourites in the comments and I'll be sure to check them out. As always, thanks for watching and I look forward to seeing you all next time.